Man, oh man, this is something that means a lot to me. This is a video I've been trying to do for a while because of being a social media company, being a marketing agency, we see this more than anything. And that is when creators and businesses, but specifically creators, give up on social media or they stop making posts or they just don't see the end game of putting in a long-term effort into social media. There's a couple reasons for that. There's a couple hard truths that people are unwilling to accept, and I want to go through those today. Now, before I get started, make sure you smash that subscribe button, follow me, like my page. I am trying to give out as much value as possible related to digital marketing, relating to digital tools that are out there to try to help you build your audience and build your brand. All right, number one, the first hard truth about social media that it takes a little while to understand is you are always operating on limited resources. Almost always. Even the biggest companies in the world could have more resources dedicated to social media. And the reason for that is to have a complete presence on all platforms. It takes at minimum one person per platform to do it right, to answer every single comment, to get back to every person, to execute and message people that are interested in your brand, to go out and make native content to that platform, size it properly, make videos. To do everything properly, you need one person dedicated per platform. And that's why there's a lot of brands out there where they have one person trying to execute all platforms. They don't see the results across all platforms they're looking for. The first hard truth is you don't have enough resources. But how do you tackle that? You have to find a way to pick one platform, the one platform that relates the most to your business, the most to your products, and dedicate 80% of the time that you're putting into social media into that one platform. And when I say 80, there's fluctuations, that 90, 70, somewhere in that range. It's gonna change day to day. But put 80% of that time into that platform. For example, if you're selling a beautiful product and you know Instagram's the place for you, make sure you're putting 80% of your time into making native pictures, making them really nice, making IGTV, building videos that are square, 1080 by 1080, to put onto Instagram and make it as native as possible to the audience that you're creating on that platform. Get out there, message other people that are like-minded and have like-minded products. Comment to every single person that comments on your posts. Build an audience. But again, put your time into Instagram. As you build that audience, you're gonna be able to translate that brand equity to other platforms. And if you want to still execute those other platforms to have the brand validation and be credible, then you can talk about taking some of your Instagram content with the other 20% of your time and distributing that to the other platforms. Even if it's not native to Facebook, you can still take some of those Instagram posts, put them straight to Facebook. Even if it's not native to LinkedIn and you think there's a benefit there, fire it off to LinkedIn. You can still create that credibility other places. It's just not gonna be native, like you're dedicating your 80% time into Instagram. Number two, the second hard truth about social media marketing is lack of time. And it kind of goes with lack of resources from number one, but lack of time comes, and it's a personal one to me because even for my personal brand, for the Magnolias brand, for brands we deal with, we have a lack of time and you have to find those extra hours to dedicate into that 80% you're putting into one platform. If I'm trying to execute YouTube, we're up till 2 in the morning trying to write the descriptions, trying to find the tags, trying to upload things outside of regular hours when you're doing your regular job. So you have to find that extra time to dedicate to these platforms and if you're gonna make it work, if you're gonna build an audience, and if you see the long-term value of creating a social media audience, that's gonna translate throughout your product, throughout your career, and take your brand to the next level. Okay, number three. With social media platforms, one of the mistakes we see a lot of people make is they're not making native content to that platform. And that's, again, because of a little bit of lack of resource and a little bit of lack of time. But native content, native to that platform, is key. And what I mean by that is a couple different things. Native in terms of the look of what people are looking for on that platform, in terms of the sound when you're making videos, in terms of the size of videos, in terms of what's trending, whether it has a progress bar or a title on your videos, Those types of things are trends that go up and down. What's important is that you see what's popular on that platform now and then make your content native to what people are looking for on that specific platform. So if you're taking content from, like I said earlier, if you're taking content from Instagram and putting it on Facebook, what's native on Instagram isn't necessarily native on Facebook. So if you want to be native on both, you're going to have to rework that picture, or you're going to have to rework that video to then be native to the Facebook platform. Obviously, there's correlations between the two that kind of cross between all platforms, but making it native is important. What works on Facebook isn't going to immediately work on LinkedIn, and it's important to understand that. Number four, this is key. Social media is a long-term game. And we see so many people dedicate a ton of time into it and then drop off. They fall off the bandwagon and they don't continue. I think the reason for that, or I know the reason for that, is there is not a direct ROI into making that content in the beginning when there's no audience built. I see so many creators when they start social media, the first thing they say to me is they say, how am I gonna monetize this? If all you're looking to do is monetize social media and that's your number one goal, you're only looking for ROI, I know you're not gonna last long enough to build the audience required to do that. It's because when you're building that audience, the last thing you wanna do to them from day one is try to sell them on something. Sales messages are getting skipped over faster than ever. People are scrolling through their feeds. There's so much noise and it's all sales messages. So what happens is your content is learned to get skipped over and the audience and the effort you're putting in goes to waste as soon as you start having those monetizing and sales messages in your content. So what you have to do is build content of value, build an audience that looks for the content you're presenting to them on a day-to-day basis. As soon as you sell, you're gonna lose. Look at social media from a long-term game. Look at it, look 5 years out, look 10 years out, look what it's going to do for your brand and for your product down the road. And don't worry about monetizing it from day one. It'll automatically happen on its own as soon as you build the audience, as soon as you start to create that value. Remember, value is always going to equal value and that's not going to change. So stay top of mind and it'll come. Number five, authenticity, which is huge on social media. Nobody is looking for someone who fakes it anymore. Everyone can see through that. If you're sitting in front of a house with a Lamborghini, people know that Lamborghini was rented. So what you have to do is you have to find a way to be as authentic as possible to your product and to your personal brand. Be yourself and create content. If you're not good at making videos, then go do pictures. Do what's authentic to you. If you're really good at making blogs, then do blogs. Do what you're good at. And what that's going to do is it's going to translate into better content that's authentic to you and to your brand. So building on that, let's go to number six, which is focus on your strengths. I just talked about it. If you're just dealing with your resources, trying to build a social media presence, do what you can to focus on your strengths and then supplement your strengths with outside resources when possible. So again, if you're really good at writing, then blog content and instant articles on Facebook are the way to go. Create that content and people are gonna see the value come through because that's what you're good at. That's what's the most authentic to you. If you're good at being behind a camera, even if you're willing to put in the time to learn how to be behind the camera and be yourself, then go and do that. Go get the equipment and get out there and make that content. It's important. And then when you want good pictures and you wanna go out and have a photographer come in because you're not good at taking those pictures, then supplement what you're good at with someone coming in to help you to make that. Number seven, you can't worry about the small details because revisions are going to kill your resources, kill your time. So things like today even, I'm not fully shaved. Sometimes I don't like how I look when I haven't shaved in the morning, but that doesn't mean this video isn't gonna go out. It doesn't mean we're not gonna take this opportunity to make content today. The smallest details that worry you aren't going to get seen by the other people watching the content. So recognize that the itty bitty is not gonna get noticed and get content out as quick as possible with as little revisions as possible. The more you can do that, you're gonna make more content and your content's gonna take you further and faster than ever before. Number eight, research, research, research. One of the questions that always comes up for me is how to crack the code of the algorithms of social media? And the hard truth is there's no cracking the code. There's no shortcuts, there's no way to know. The algorithm changes all of the time and we don't even know what it's changing to. Focus on researching on what works on that platform, what's native, and then focus on three common sense items that I always say. Number one, be social. You have to be social with other people. Social media by name means that we're going on and interacting with others and being social. Number two, keep people on that platform longer. The longer you keep people on the specific platform, the more that platform can retarget and sell ads to the people that you're keeping on that platform. So they want you to keep people on their platform longer. Don't push people to other platforms. Keep people on the specific platform you're creating content on, and your content will do better. And last but not least is create engagement. It's not the most important, because the people within your sphere, the people that are seeing the content in the beginning, are going to see your content. You're going to stay top of mind, even if they're not commenting and liking on it. But interaction is important on your content to allow it to go. How do you do that? Well, build your audience. Go be social with other people. Create content that gives value back to the audience that you're building. And create and correct. So build content, and based on what is creating engagement, then correct on the next one and correct on the next one. The first piece of content that you make that you think is good might not be good or might not give value to your audience. Last but not least, number nine, don't take shortcuts. Of everything I said today, take this one the most seriously. There is no shortcuts on social media. There's no way to push your content further and faster by taking a shortcut. There's no hack. There's no way to make it go further. It is all about hard work and hustle to make your content and to create this engagement and audience that everybody wants. What I mean by this is there's no way to outsource authentic content that you're making yourself or authentic text strings. There's no way to third party and send out and get pictures or graphics made somewhere else and have someone schedule it and make the text strings and post it for you. It all has to be done by you. It all has to be done by the creator. It all has to be done by the heart of the brand. Take this one seriously. It's one of the things that I see happen a lot and people don't realize it. I see a lot of questions saying, how can I fit this into my schedule? How can I find that hack? How can I make more content and have someone do it for cheap? It just doesn't work. It doesn't get you where you want to go. And that's where I see so many people drop off the bandwagon and stop making content. So no shortcuts, and it's going to take you further. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. I'm just getting my YouTube channel going, and it means so much to me that you got through the video, and I hope that you took some value away from it. If you did, please leave some comments below. Tell me how to improve. Tell me how to create and correct, and smash that subscribe button. I'm going to be making videos like this every single week, trying to give you as much value as possible about digital marketing and the digital world. Thanks a lot.